Welcome to worship at American Lutheran Church in Sun City. So good to be with you. God bless America. Happy 4th of July. Thank you, God, for equipping us with the people and the skills and the talents, the unity of purpose. Yes, we struggle, but this is a land that is blessed by God's presence and by the encouragement for one another. I pray this service encourages you. And the phrase, God bless America, is our hope and our prayer. Sometimes I hear that, and it's almost like a demand, God bless America, or a flat statement, God bless America. It is our prayer, our hope. And the amazing thing is that to bless America, God uses us to proclaim the gospel and to be warm and inviting to bring people into faith. And in all we do, in all we say, as best as we can, together, that we bless in word and deed. This is halfway through the church year. I encourage you, for those who support our church financially, take a look at where you're at. I would say the math is this. If you make a pledge, you should be halfway fulfilling that pledge. Here we are completing these first 6 months. And come and join us. And for those who are looking forward to maybe taking that next step in faith, your tithes, your offerings are used for the proclamation of the gospel and to continue to strengthen the ministry here at American Lutheran Church. I'm so thankful through technology we're together. So for this purpose, there will be some hymns that you know. There are going to be some readings from Scripture that strengthen our understanding of the goodness of God. And for this time, in this place, I start with this prayer. Thank you, God, for the gift of life in the United States of America. As we declare our independence in 1776, we now declare our dependence upon you in this worship service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us sing. Day. God of the covenant, in our baptism, you call us to proclaim the coming of your kingdom. Give us the courage you gave the apostles that we may faithfully witness to your love and peace in every circumstance of life. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Christians do not boast in their own accomplishments. Rather, Christian boasting focuses attention on how the power of Christ is present in our lives, especially in times of weakness and vulnerability. No matter what our circumstances in life, Christ's grace is sufficient for us. We read today from St. Paul's second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 12, verses 2 through 10. I know a person in Christ who 14 years ago was caught up to the third heaven. Whether in the body or out of the body, I do not know. God knows. And I know that such a person, whether in the body or out of the body, I do not know. God knows. Was caught up into paradise and heard things that are not to be told, that no mortal is permitted to repeat. On behalf of such a one, I will boast. But on my own behalf, I will not boast, except of my weaknesses. But if I wish to boast, I will not be a fool, for I will be speaking the truth. But I refrain from it, so that no one may think better of me than what is seen in me or heard from me, even considering the exceptional character of the revelations. Therefore, to keep me from being too elated, a thorn was given me in the flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me, to keep me from being too elated. 3 times I appealed to the Lord about this, that it would leave me. But he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. So I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may dwell in me. Therefore, I am content with weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamities for the sake of Christ. For whenever I am weak, then I am strong." The word of the Lord.
Our psalm for today, for the sixth Sunday after Pentecost, is Psalm 123, read responsively. To you I lift up my eyes, to you enthroned in the heavens.
As the eyes of the servants look to the hand of their masters, and the eyes of a maid to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to you, O Lord our God, until you show us your mercy.
Have mercy upon us, O Lord, have mercy, for we have had more than enough of contempt.
Too much of the score of the indolent rich and of the derision of the proud.
As we continue in this season of Pentecost, of spiritual growth and renewal, we hear of Jesus returning home and then sending people out in his name. The gospel is taken from the 6th chapter of Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus came to his hometown and his disciples followed him. On the Sabbath, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were astounded. They said, "Where did this man get all this? What is this wisdom that has been given to him? What deeds of power are being done by his hands? Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, and brother of James, and Joseph, and Judas, and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Then Jesus said to them, "Prophets are not without honor, except in their hometown, and among their own kin, and in their own house." And he could do no deed of power there, except he laid his hands on a few sick people and cured them. And he was amazed at their unbelief. Then he went among the villages teaching, and he called the 12 and began to send them out 2 by 2 and gave them authority over the unclean spirits. And he ordered them to take nothing for their journey except a staff, no bread, no bag, no money in their belts, but to wear sandals and not to put on 2 tunics. And he said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave the house. And if any place will not welcome you and they refuse to hear you as you leave, shake off the dust that is on your feet as a testimony against them." And so they went out and proclaimed that all should repent. And they cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace, peace, and love through our wonderful, powerful God, our amazing Savior, and the spiritual renewal of the Holy Spirit who captures this time and this place to hear the message of God through Scripture. God bless America. It's a beautiful song. It's a plaintive plea. As Americans, we have done well, haven't we? This country has been a tremendous force for good in the world. It is certainly needful for critique when we lose our way and our policies do not reflect the beginning of who we are about. We are people who believe in the truth. And that's kind of a simple way to describe America, but we started this Declaration of Independence with these words. We hold these truths to be self-evident. Now, I'll stop right there and say, I think that they're self-evident because God discloses them. But in this knowledge of our country that all men are created equal and endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life and liberty and, importantly, the pursuit of happiness, not the guarantee of happiness, but the freedom. And as you may know, you don't try to be happy. Remember the song, "Don't Worry, Be Happy." That's not so much it, but in meaningful aspects of life and liberty, the freedom to live and to serve and love, happiness is a beautiful byproduct. And to secure these rights, that we are the people who are governed, and not by power that comes through government, but the government derives their power from the consent of the governed. These are fundamental. This is who we're about, but it's about truth. And it is a unity that we live together for the support of this declaration. At the end, it said it this way, a firm reliance on the protection of divine providence, and that we mutually pledge to each other our lives, our fortunes, and our sacred honor. That brings a tear to my eye because I think about the integrity of that commitment. We now, as the people of the United States, struggling on many policy issues, struggling on complex issues, very complex systemic issues. I'm just thinking of healthcare. I'm thinking of transportation. I'm thinking of education, a whole variety of issues. And this commitment to pledge our lives and our resources within a sacred, or we'll say a holy purpose, a sacred honor. We're in this together, right? Holy meaning set apart for a special purpose. Secular meaning common things. Yeah, we have things in common for sure, but that type of commitment, God blesses America when we live with that type of integrity and that commitment to support one another, to live for the purpose of being together and being a force for good. And that may seem a little idealistic sometimes, but it truly is the special dynamic. God bless America, and it's through us, this invitation to be people of blessing. We came from kind of a ragtag collection of people. Now that's, I don't mean to be insulting, but the British government and the word that we don't like any more than we used to, king, that one person would have authority over us. Psalm 123 says it this way, have mercy upon us, O Lord, have mercy. And this was said as people were marching. This is a psalm of ascent, Psalm 123, as you're marching up to Jerusalem for the high and holy festivals. And this phrase, because we've had too much of the scorn of the indolent rich and the derision of the proud. We are people that are common. We are the common man, the common woman, that we are looking for that safety, that there is no single person or system that treats us with contempt. We are those people, and we are certainly a blessing when we support one another in this regards. There's an amazing fighting spirit about the American life, and that is that we have a sense of agency. That phrase means that we have the ability to make a move, that we can do things that, yes, there may be constraints, certainly of time and energy and money, and there may be people competing against us in different ways, but that we have this understanding that we're in this together and that we have the ability to be free to move in our action. But the freedom we have, and as a Christ follower, I invite you to look at it this way, is that we understand life will be difficult. Pursuit of happiness does not mean that we are happy to pursue only happiness. It means that in our pursuits and of meaning and purpose, that there will be challenges. And Paul says it in our reading here of 2 Corinthians chapter 12. And as he had an experience of the heavenly places, that he spoke about this, that I will not boast, but I'm going to boast in my weakness. I love our country. One of the things I love about our country is we're willing to pray where we need God's help. The United States, of course, demonstrates strength through military might and others, but economic strength, all those issues. But I love our country because we pray for where we are weak. We need God's loving mercy and power. The power of love is what we pray for. And there are gaps everywhere that we pray and we admit our weaknesses. It's a really neat way of looking at it. God's power that will help in our weakness. I said it this way that Paul said, I don't want anybody to think better of me, what is seen in me or heard from me. That authenticity, that's another part of America. We don't like the talk, we like to see it in action. And so in doing this thorn in the flesh that he mentioned, he prayed for the pain to be taken away. But the Lord in response said, my grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness. God's power, perfect, meaning for a purpose, towards a teleological goal. And what is that? The redemption of this world. And the power of Christ is so much more than our own power. Unified when we pray for God's blessing upon our country, for all the weakness of our efforts and for the challenges we have, our sin, for the persecutions and the calamities, as Paul said it, of Christ. Whenever I am weak, then I am strong. When we pray and we have a life of prayer and we're willing to speak the truth, God bless America, because then we're open to this encouragement of God's power and purpose and presence in our life. God bless America so that we can be a blessing for this whole world that God loves. God so loves this world. The gospel promise that comes in this way, he returns home. Jesus comes home and people are astounded. And the words that are translated in this way, that the people took offense at Jesus because they're seeing God's action revealed, a blessing for sure, and yet limited by the human dynamics of hometown. You know, I've returned from a trip with my brother to commemorate our parents' final resting place. Unable to do that last year with the pandemic, and so it was really a moving time. And we went to one of the congregations that Mom and Dad had served at, and that was in West Point, Nebraska, and it was hilarious to me. My brother and I went inside. There was a quilting group. Oh, these are our people. And as we kind of bantered with the people, do you remember us? They bypassed me and they went to Jim. It was really funny. And they said, you know, we really found you to be funny and full of life, even though if your parents didn't appreciate it. He was kind of, well, you know, Sunday school. He needed to learn how to behave. And it was so funny to see his face because he did not expect them to remember him like that. Isn't that funny? The preacher's kid remembered after all these years. It is an amazing thing that when you go back home, right, you're just part of the community. You're no better. You're no worse. And the limitations is, let's just never treat Jesus that way. Yes, comfort as our Redeemer and as our Savior, and yes, as friend, but never to diminish the power of what God can do to bless America through the love of Christ. That is easy. And sometimes the church has struggled. And so we are struggling now to regain this deeds of power, to not diminish our Christian religion or the religion of America into just a simple commodity. It's our time. God bless America through the wonderful realization of God's love in Christ. And then this sense of agency again. Jesus sending out people. Light load. Right? I mean, you read this, right? Do not take anything for your journey. Oh, good Lord. I just overpacked once again. You want to make sure you have things for different types of weather. And here he is saying these phrases for the journey of mission. You take your staff and you take your sandals and you have your tunic, one tunic, but no bread, no bag, no money. Oh my goodness gracious. Dependent totally upon the reception of people. It's also a leveling effect. And our country has a lot of work to do to level the playing field, that we are no one being held in contempt, that there is not the indolent rich, that there is not the derision of the proud. And there's always a pecking order, isn't there? And maybe we aren't at the top, obviously, but that is not America. This is the land of opportunity, of these phrases, of understanding that God's love is for all. So as I see this, as he sent his people out, light, nimble, able to love and to serve, proclaiming that all should repent, for our modern day, that means turn to God, give up on that which is taking you away from God, love one another, the simple messages of the kingdom of God. And it doesn't take a lot of time or energy, it just takes that lightness of being, that sense of agency that you and I, in this time, for this 2021 July 4th weekend, is that we are part of this blessing called America. God bless America is not a demand. God bless America is not simply a song to start off a Kiwanis or Rotary meeting. God bless America is our plaintive plea. Mercy upon this land, Lord, and the encouragement for all of us to be able to look at the truth. We are truth tellers, and when we open ourselves to our weakness as a country and we need your help, Lord, when we open ourselves to the weakness in our own life and where we need help, Lord, when we open ourselves to the weakness in our community and work together to do this in a way without contempt, with tremendous regard, we start bringing this kingdom. We start moving forward with this sense of agency. This is the final encouragement for you. When we ask for God blessing America, that's you and me in this community of faith, in our communities in which we live. We are called to be a blessing. And so I'm so thankful for this mid-year checkup point. We're proclaiming the gospel. We're inviting others to join us in this faith community. And we're seeking to be a blessing in what we say and what we do. Check yourself. Take a look at the truth. The proclamation of the gospel. Thanks for being part of this worship. Inviting others. Who are you encouraging in your family and friends and neighbors to go deeper in faith and to join you online or in person? And being a blessing, continue to utilize your gifts and times and talents to strengthen this church, to rebound it out into the world so that the blessing of God's love is for this country and obviously for the world. God bless America, land that we love. Stand beside her and guide her. Thank you, God, for this weekend in which we are encouraged to live with the humbleness of knowing your mercy, with the action and the agency that we have, even in our weaknesses, calling upon your love. And this light load of moving in the mission, not diminishing Jesus for his power and for his love, but moving forward with the strength and encouragement, two by two, out into the world, and bringing the good news of God's blessing. In Jesus' name, may you be strengthened. God bless America. begin our prayer time with our offertory prayer. Merciful Father, we offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, all signs of your gracious love. Receive them for the sake of him who offered himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us come before the triune God in prayer. God, bless America. Thank you for the gift of freedom. Thank you for this country. And even in the challenges in which we experience the difficulty of unity of direction, give us the encouragement to love, to serve, to live boldly in your name. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of all, through the waters of baptism, you claim people of all races, ethnicities, and languages as your beloved children. Sustain the baptized and increase our faith that your gospel may be proclaimed throughout the earth. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God, you are God of freedom, and you have liberated us from sin and death, and rescue us from all forms of spiritual and social and political oppression. Defend us from tyrants in our midst, and deliver us from all forms of slavery or corruption. Direct our freedom to liberate others and to bring wholeness in the name of Christ. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God, you are God of compassion, and you became vulnerable in the person of Jesus Christ in solidarity with the disempowered. Strengthen those who feel faint. Give courage to those who fear. Bring wholeness to all in need. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God, you are a God of holiness, set apart for a special purpose, and you send us out into the world to proclaim your love. So strengthen our ministry of outreach. Equip us as we leave this place to witness and to serve our neighbors in love. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And we give you thanks that in every time and place you call forth prophets who move us, encourage us towards freedom. Thank you, God, for all who strive for liberty in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And so we lift our prayers to you, O God, trusting in your abiding grace through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Oh,
So as we conclude our worship service, I wanted to thank you for being part of this community of faith. You are a blessing. When you hold the truth in your life, that there are weaknesses that we have, but we are united. We are a people who, at our best, are of a common dimension, a common unity, not separated from the proud and the poor, but together seeking the pursuit of happiness by living a life of liberty and freedom. And that we have this sense of agency that we can do these things depending upon God's power for our weaknesses, that we are able to move. And don't diminish this country. Don't diminish, importantly, more importantly, the power of God. Do not make it like that hometown experience where everybody goes, oh, we know who you are. No, Lord, open us up and the simple ways to proclaim and to invite others and to be a blessing in what you say and what you do truly is a blessing for America. May God strengthen us. And may the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And in this time, in this tender time for our country, God bless America and equip and encourage us to be the agents of blessing for the land in which you love. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the power of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, God bless you.